there's a, or your a peer assessment rubric. So you would go to your assignments, and that should be in there. Hopefully I did it right. A peer assessment rubric that you need to fill out. The fourth big thing today is the reflection sheet from your last writing prompt, which I'll try to explain in groups that are over here. So with that, if you need to find your paper from the, from the last writing prompt. So if you were in Guzman's class, you look through that file. And Trace, look through that file. I'll give you a chance if you haven't done it. A lot of you did that. What we'll do is I'll pull people over here, and you're, when you come over, well, see, there's the problem. Maybe you won't be told, maybe you won't. But when it's your group's time, say it's this group, it's their group's time to do the reflection sheet, they're going to then look at the scores. You're going to look at your score that you gave and. Why do some of these guys give scores? Okay, you all were supposed to give your own score, and then there was two other scores on there. There's going to be a sheet that you're going to reflect on that as well. If your scores are different than what the teacher scores were, you're going to look at the rubric. You're going to use this card to reflect what you think, what was different. Why was your score, what you thought was a three, the teacher's thought was a one. All right, so those are the things that we're going to work on, those four things. I don't know, we're going to try to make this work the best we can. All right, the other thing is it needs to be, a quiet time so that group when they're talking can hear. So I guess if I'm saying, for a while, you guys are finishing editing, and you're done with that. One of the things on the bell work was to do what? To have what? Last. One of the things, and it's not, I didn't. You should have it, but I don't. Thank you, Mrs. Nelson. Is to have a free reading book. So if you have, I haven't gone to your table and said, hey, rotate into the next thing, you're going to do a free reading book. Also on the bell works, the rest of you, unless Mrs. Nelson might be coming through, looks like you're ready, the rest of you right now, make sure you have turned in your yesterday's, global issues presentation notes. Make sure you do that right now. Everyone make sure you've done that, everyone find there. So this is what we're going to do in a couple minutes. Make sure you submit that, make sure you have this, and make sure you have a reading book. I'm going to give you a couple minutes. Those are three readings right now. Make sure you have a reading book. Make sure you submit it. This is no work. And make sure you have your writing prompt. Thank you.
first two and see how long it takes us, okay? Okay, here we go.
Okay.
So speak loudly.
So the first question is, what was the most rewarding part of this Power in Government Global Issues Project? I think the most rewarding part was all of the facts we learned and
stuff. Hey, what do you feel like you learned most about Hiroshi during this year?
I think we learned that we should not take things for granted because other people don't have what we have.
And to be grateful for what we have.
Which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were the most successful with during this year?
What is one thing that you want people to know about your global issue?
You guys should take things for granted.
Yeah.
Yeah, I
would.
Okay, next question. On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you give the student and why?
I would give the student 8 because I liked how we learned about issues because, like, we never really, like, you know about other things that's happening.
I'd give this unit a 9 because it's pretty good, but, like, I don't think it will. Actually, a 10 because I can't think of anything bad with it.
I'll give this unit a 9 because we learned about other people that, like, they have stuff we have.
I give this you a 9 because I like to be grateful for what I have.
That's all.
Same.
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 Okay, what do we do now?
Okay, we're trying to get these kids to talk louder. It's a little frustrating. Hey, is anyone in here watching besides Noah? No. I don't want you to. Okay, we're going to try this without. That's because you did it out loud to everybody. We're going to try without the mic.
Group 2, where are ya? Where are ya?
Here we go. Neat, neat, neat. Let's see if we can get you in here. Got you a little bit closer. There, look at my hair. Oh my gosh. Okay. Ready?
Good.
Okay. So, what was the most rewarding part of this Power in Government unit? What I liked the best was getting to create our organization, like filling out the rubric and deciding like what our logo is going to be and stuff. My favorite part, I agree with you, that was my favorite part also because we got to like do what we wanted to do and yeah. Okay, what do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this unit? I used to think that, like, overpopulation was really a problem because we had a bunch of space in the world, but after I researched this, I found out that we actually don't have as much space as we think.
I feel like I learned that there's more parts of the world that are overcrowded and they're having more problems around the world, like, more problems in that space. And so we need to do something about it to stop overpopulation.
Which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were most successful with during this unit? I feel like our collaboration and communication with each other was really good because we all participated, except for Chris. And we all helped out and pitched in with our part of the project that we needed to do.
I agree as well that collaboration and communication was our best because we got a lot of work done by communicating and we worked well together.
What is one thing you want people to know about your global issue? I want people to, well, I don't want to interrupt the class.
No, you get to interrupt the class. You guys are on stage. Jazzy and
I want people to know that, like, with our population growing, we're losing a lot of, like, farmland that we could be using for, like, making food and producing food, and if we're not producing enough food, then people are going to be going hungry very soon, if they're not yet.
One thing that I want people to know about overpopulation is that there are lots of places in the world that are overcrowded. You probably already know that, but, like, some places are running out of resources because of it, and people are going hungry. So, and
on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what would you give this unit and why? I would give this unit about an 8 or a 9 because I really like this unit. I thought it was fun. I got to learn about a lot of things that happen in this world that I usually wouldn't, like, want to learn about or have interest in. And, like, I would like to learn more about some things because they are big issues that should be addressed more often.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I would give it a 7 or 8. This is our chance to, like, help a global issue outside of where we live. So, like, overpopulation is a big problem all over the world, so, like, we could help other people and try to find a problem to stop.
Okay. Thank you.
Say goodbye to each other.
Goodbye! What was the most rewarding part of this power and government global issues project? I feel like it was the fact that we got to help people who needed it or raise awareness for global issues that need to be solved.
I think it was the most rewarding part was, like, how we got to learn about the different topics and try to, like, help all the topics.
I think it was most rewarding because we got to, like, figure out stuff and help people in need, I guess.
What do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this unit? I feel like I learned that a lot about hunger and where it's most prominent and what we need to do to solve it.
I learned that a lot of food is getting wasted more than I actually thought.
Which new tech learning outcome, NTLO, do you feel like you were most successful with during this unit?
Well, I feel like I was most successful with oral communication because of the, like, the live stream we did yesterday.
I think
the best one was collaboration because we were all working together while we were all collaborating.
Yeah, I think so too, because we were all working as a group, not messing around and getting our work done.
What is one thing you want people to know about your global issue?
For me, probably that 1 in 9 people around the world are hungry, but in Texas, 1 in 6 people are hungry.
I think, that people should
mostly know
is, if we stop wasting food and then just, save food,
that there would be a lot less people around going hungry. Yeah, just save food and maybe it could save lives.
On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest and 10 being the highest, what would you give this unit and why?
I'd give it a 7 out of 10. I kind of like this unit, but there were some things that could have been, less time learning about just the United Nations and more time spent actually learning about our topic.
I would give it, an 8 because, it was a good, way to learn about all the global issues and what we need to help save the world.
I'll give it a 7 because it was pretty fun and I like that we worked as a group and got our stuff done instead of slacking and not getting work done.
Okay, all right. So what we're going to do, what you guys are going to do right now is
Make sure every other speaking voice
is my face.
Well, you still need to participate with your group. Okay, so make sure everyone's in. Please make sure you speak loudly, okay? And answer each question. And you have to be able to reflect, okay? Do you need to take a break? Well, you're not writing, you're talking.
I know, I don't know.
Okay.
So the first question says, what was the most rewarding part of this power in government global issues project? I would say the most rewarding part is getting to know that you can, like, help, even if it's in a small way. Like, still help.
I think the most rewarding part was teaching people that there is a way to stop global warming, and you can do it by something simple, by planting a tree.
I think the most rewarding part was, like telling people what our organization is and how they can, like, do, like, plant one tree and still help.
Okay, the second question is, what do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this unit? I feel like we learned that, yes, again, you can still help in a simple way, like recycling or planting a tree, and you can feel good about yourself after doing that.
I think the most rewarding part was getting to know that you can help, you can persuade others to do good for your community.
I think, like, thinking you can help, or, like, helping. I think we learned most about, like, what deforestation is and how you can prevent that from happening, and, like, yeah.
Third question is, what new tech learning outcome in TLO do you feel like you were the most successful with during this unit? So, I think we were the most successful with agency because we really worked together to find how you can help climate change and help prevent in the community.
I think, I feel like we were most successful with agency also because we worked together to find all the research we needed to create our organization.
I think that as well. told that agency is the best because we worked together to come up with what we were doing and how we were going to present what we were talking about.
Okay, the fourth question is, what is the one thing you want people to know about your global issue? I would say how you can help a global issue in a very small way and still help prevent it, because if you plant one tree, you're still helping to stop that issue in your community.
I think what I want people to know is that you can plant a tree and that can absorb at least 48 pounds of carbon dioxide from the air, and that's helping the environment.
I'd say what deforestation is and how you can prevent it by planting trees and recycling.
Okay, the fifth question is, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what would you give this unit and why? I said I would give it a 9 because I feel like we could have done better in our presentation explaining and persuading more people to plant trees to help prevent deforestation.
I think I give it a 9 as well because we did pretty good getting all the research we needed. I just think that the presentation could have been a little more clear and a little more persuasive to others.
I'd give it a 9 as well because we did good on the research, but when we were presenting, we talked a little fast and yeah.
Okay, that's it.
Let's go through the questions. I have them there for you. So read the question, reflect on the unit. You're good.
Okay. What was the most rewarding part?
In a little bit. Sorry.
What was the most rewarding part of the Power on Government Global Issues project?
I think for us, it was probably getting to know and to learn about the Irrawaddy dolphins and their
cause. Yeah, I like to learn about the Irrawaddy dolphins a lot because A, they're really cute, and B, I didn't know that dolphins could learn.
Nothing. Let's see, I don't know. What do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this meeting?
Most of the world can't drink the water that much. Okay, next question. Which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were the most successful with during this unit?
I would say collaboration because we did work very well together, even though that most of us had differences that like, we had problems with.
Like sometimes we had arguments over whether to do this or that.
We had little spats about things that weren't like
important. Yeah, related to that topic.
But they did really stress, and so I think that was a good thing.
What is the one thing you want people to know about your global issue? To clean up the water.
That we have a limited supply of it, and we need to treat it well. We need to like not use as much as we have now. We can't waste it because we do need the water.
And that people with clean water should take it very well because most people in the world do not have clean water to drink.
On a scale from 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what would you give this unit and why?
Give it about a 3. I'd give it a 4 to 5.
I would give it a 7 because we did learn a lot. Because we did learn a lot about what's wrong with our world and how we need to help it.
I would also give it a 7 because we learned a lot about water resources and we learned about water pollution and how most of our water we cannot drink.
That's it. Thank you.
Goodbye. I don't know.
Yes. Hey, scoot in a little bit, Jordan. Great. You ready? Use your teacher voice, Brittany. Let me hear it. Jazzy hands. Jazzy hands. All right. Ready? Go.
Okay. What was the most rewarding part of powering government global issues and problems? I think the most rewarding part was putting together like the projects and coming up with ideas on how to like solve the global issue.
I think with her, just putting it together, creating an idea, making it look great is probably the most rewarding parts of this unit.
Yeah, the hardest part was putting it together. It was kind of challenging just doing that.
What do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this unit?
I guess we learned a lot about
our global issue and pollution and how it's affecting our environment.
We learned a lot about how pollution affects this earth and how the great impact that we saw on our earth and how it really affects our wildlife and us. And everything we used to live.
Yeah, it's kind of just like learning like how what like the water pollution and everything just does to like does to people and animals during it.
Which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were the most successful with during this year?
Yeah.
Yeah, the slides.
Yeah, probably just putting together the slides. Each other's slides.
Yeah, and collecting and researching information.
And getting images of what it means and information.
Yeah, and writing it. Write down earlier where we got to see like, what that slide is.
Yeah. What is one thing you want people to know about your global issue? One thing I guess I want people to know about our global issue is that pollution is really affecting our environment, and it's really affecting the animals and the people and everyone else who lives in the environment, and that we really need to make a difference and like help save our environment.
We also think people should learn about pollution because it affects the citizens of Iowa, our wildlife, and a bunch of things we used to live, make homes out of. And pollution affects our water, our air.
Yeah, I agree with that guy right there. Because, pollution does affect a lot of people, animals, and the environment.
On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what would you give this feeling?
8?
I think I would give this like an 8 or 9.
Because
I really liked how like we were learning about like our different global issues and like how those issues burden the people everywhere.
And also, we actually learned a lot about pollution, and we learned some new things about it, how it affects Earth and everything we use on Earth. Yes, me. Jordan, your turn.
Okay, I'd probably give it about a 4 or 5, because I liked it, and I also didn't like it sometimes, so they get kind of boring a lot.
Yeah, I guess, like, it's
sometimes
difficult.
It really boring.
Doing work.
I guess the difficult part was like researching the information
did a four
and
for the
finding like the different facts about different places. And yeah, I guess that was the difficult part.
Yeah. That's all. Goodbye.
No, do not close the eye. WWC News.
What is so cool with them? They're great.
Graham, go to play. Let's sing a song.
Bing Bing.
Oh, Ella. Oh, it's my...
Thank you.
so I just want to double check where we're at. So that went a little bit faster than what fine. I want to make sure is everyone in this room. You guys can start, right?
No.
Everyone in this room has handed me in your note card about the writing prompt. If you haven't, I need it. Everyone in this room has handed me back in the actual writing prompt. If you haven't, do so. Okay? Next, raise your hand if you have filled out your peer reflection. If you've not filled out your peer reflection, you're going to raise. You need to do that. Then I think at this point, Mrs. Nelson might be coming around and checking each group to see where you're at with your writing, your actual writing of your letter. Okay? So that means then, if you're not working on your writing letter and you're writing an envelope, you are reading. And in your very quiet time, I can't focus on reading when I'm hearing noise. So you're getting, some of you are going to get a nice chance to just relax. Read if you're not over there or you're not working on your letter. Okay.
2 more minutes. Where's Cameron?
Do you have to wait for her?
Oh, yeah.
She's stuck up.
I'm sorry. You know, I don't know what I'm talking about. Oh, nobody's watching me.
So you came in safely.
I know, right? I'm just like, where's Cameron?
What
is
Ansley?
Stop bothering
me.
Shoot. No. I hope I'm talking back.
Cameron, come in. See?
I'm touching my eyelashes. Cameron's not here. Do we just start?
Okay.
Okay.
Just waiting for you to speak.
Okay. The first question is, what was the most rewarding part of this Power and Government and Global Issue project? I think the most rewarding part of this project.
You guys get to talk as loud as you want because you're the show.
Watching.
You're the show.
Okay. I think the most rewarding part of this project was working together.
I think you liked working with him.
Yeah.
Kind of.
I think the most rewarding part was probably actually finishing the project. Because it was kind of a difficult project.
Naya, you have to scoot yourself out. Here we go. Scoot yourself in.
Cameron, you have to say the most rewarding part of this project. Huh? Okay, you don't have to answer that. Okay, the next question is, what do you feel like you learned most about your issue during this unit? I think I learned that even though globalization is good, we need to look out for the negative things so we can fix it. Hello.
Hello.
Go.
What did you learn most?
I think we learned that the actual meaning of globalization.
Speak louder.
At the beginning, I don't think all of us knew exactly what it meant.
Okay.
No, don't put it too much. Just have Cameron.
Cameron, go.
Hello. I think.
That's a big, like. But you know what?
I think.
Funny,
I think.
That, that microphone's not even on.
She was talking in it.
Because it's. Sorry, I should have told you that. We unplugged it because actually this is louder.
Keep going.
Okay, Cameron, I think I learned that globalization isn't just bad things.
It has good things.
Okay, let's go.
Which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were the most successful with during the CMS?
We all think agency because we turn all of our projects in on time, so we pick agency.
Okay, next question, introduce it.
What is the one thing you want?
Louder.
What is the one
thing? Okay. Remember, we're live streaming.
What is the one thing you want people to know about your global issue?
Negative things about globalization needs to be monitored and fixed.
Go.
I think that
She agrees with me that negative things needs to be monitored. Louder.
What?
I will give this unit a 5 because some days we worked together well and then some days we didn't work together well. So we picked a 5. I picked a 5.
I'll say a 4 because this thing, I didn't really connect to it. I didn't really like 5 with Kanaya because I was supposed to give it a 4. I didn't really connect. And that's 4.
I give this project probably a 6 because I think most of the time our group worked together good, but at the same time, some parts of this project
that's like my
were
answer.
Hard.
That's done.
Okay,
thank you.
All right, next group. Where's my next group? There they are.
Mrs. Nelson, should we just start?
Yeah, you're ready. Yeah. You're up, friends.
So, watching.
Let's see how many people are watching.
Yeah.
Yeah. Our adoring fans. Hopefully no one's watching.
Oh, there's only two.
Oh, no!
And one of them's Noah.
Noah!
Hello to our adoring fans.
Well, the good thing, though, is that this is taped, so it's on YouTube, so you can go back and watch it.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Hello, and welcome back to NPR News. Right. I'm Lourdes here with Janet, Ida, and Julia.
And what was the most rewarding part of the Powering Government Global Issues Project?
I would say probably, like, you get to give your own input about it and, like, what... Okay,
so we
get in.
Okay, switch it over. I'll sit on her chair. There we go. Yeah, I think just giving our opinion on a certain topic was fun. And we got to learn about a thing that's like actually going on in our world.
Another part is, what do you feel like you learned the most about your issue during this project? So, like, mostly, like, I learned that, like, hate crimes, so, like, our topic was racially motivated hate crimes, and, like, I learned that hate crimes were, like, happening, like, more, like, were happening, like, more, and, like, they occur a lot, and, like, they're more serious and people try to take them less. Like, usually they don't get justice for, like, the hate crime happening. So.
And it's, like, I also learned that, like, it's hard to convict someone of a hate crime because
because of just these factors that play a role of determining whether someone did commit a hate crime or not. Anyone else?
Okay, so which new tech learning outcome and TLO do you feel like we are most successful in? I think we are really good in collaboration.
Yeah.
Like, we talked a lot of stuff out.
And, like, I think we know how to, like, sort of collaborate and, like, we came together and made this whole project.
Yeah.
And, like, also, like, with Logan, because, like, we had to do, like, a lot of research going into this, and, like, we had, like, a really, like, gigantic idea, and, like, we had to actually, like, make it, like, a whole, like, process.
Yeah. And we also did really good at, like, problem solving, like, when something didn't work out, like, when we couldn't do the certain things that we wanted to do, we came up with new ideas about how to make it better. So, what was one thing that we want people to know about our global issue?
Like, it's probably, like,
it's still a current issue right now. And it's not just something that's, like, happened a couple years ago. It's still happening, like, every 60 minutes, you know?
Yeah.
It's
so confusing.
It's mirrored. Oh, no. It's opposite mirrored.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
It's flipped. Yeah.
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what would we give this unit and why?
Probably an 8 or 9 because it was like really opinionated. I mean, I guess it's supposed to be opinionated, but like.
It also felt kind of like the last unit too, where we had an organization and we had to help a certain group. But then it was also kind of fun just being able to create our own organization and like know what it's like to put in the research of starting an organization.
Yeah, like, I would give, like, an 8 or 9, like, on a unit, because, like, it was nice, like, to get creative and stuff. Like, on a unit, I would give, like, a D and S, so, like, to be honest, like, we collaborated so well.
Yeah,
like, we all did our work, and, like, it was just, like, really fun, as we, like, talked to each other, like, outside of school, so it was, like, nice to have, like, a group who actually did like, the work.
Yeah.
We were just, like, I mean,
well, that is it for MTN News. Tune in next time.
See you.
Wait, should we leave? Should we just leave?
Are you guys finished?
Yeah.
Alright.
We decided to call it MTN News.
Love it.
I feel all right. While you scoot in.
I'm in the middle of the level.
Okay, wait. This way. I think, yeah. And
okay.
Colin can scoot in.
Am I going?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Okay, we can start.
I don't know. Speak really loud.
But then, okay. Okay. Hold on, I doubt there's one.
Okay.
Who's watching? I kind of want to
know.
Yeah. I haven't known who's watching. Should we just start?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So, first question is, what was the most rewarding part of this Power and Government United Global Issues project?
I think that it was the, we were getting, like, feedback from other groups and, like,
I don't remember what they were.
But we got a lot of good friends.
Critical
friends. Friends with other people. We got a lot of good feedback, and I think that was pretty good.
Yeah. We definitely
good feedback about, like, a lot of compliments on the work that we have been doing. They all liked our website.
Who doesn't like compliments?
I mean, yeah, you know?
What do you feel like you've learned most about your issue during this unit?
I think that we learned a lot about, like, the huge issue on health around the world, and how people are just, like, almost, like, kind of throwing their lives away because they're, like, doing things like drugs and alcohol and smoking cigarettes and stuff.
Yeah. I've learned a lot about different health issues around the world. A lot of them are in Sub-Saharan Africa, which is the poorest region in the country, or the world. And, yeah.
Okay. So.
Number three. Which new tech learning outcome, NTLO, do you feel like you were the most successful with during this unit?
We definitely collaborated very well.
Yeah, this was a great group.
I feel like we all, like, really worked together, and we all had a job, and we were all working.
Very productive.
We successfully did our jobs.
Yes. Yeah.
And we communicated really well about everything.
Number four, what is one thing you want people to know about your global issue?
Colin, would you like to answer this one?
Yes, I do. Well, we kind of wanted people to know the dangers of smoking and cost of it.
Okay. Pretty much just what you said summed it up, I guess. Okay.
On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what do you give yourself in this unit and why?
So, like, an 8.5, maybe even a 9.
Yeah, 8.5 to 9.
Yeah.
Because,
I think I just say 8.
This was an interesting, because there's a lot of stuff that I didn't know before.
Yeah. A lot of stuff.
A lot of facts.
We're done.
You're finished?
Yeah. Okay. Jazz hands, you guys.
Yay.
Colin, do jazz hands.
Great.
Bye.
Where's my last room? Not my last room, my first room. Sorry. My first room is this next section. Okay, so about 4 minutes. Sorry. Oral communication and written communication, excellent. And then what are the two that we really work on with new tech? Agency, excellent. And then economics. Yep, exactly right. Which one do you say? Sometimes we don't say that verbiage enough for them to. So that's it's okay.
So I would just find what
you. Okay, are you ready to do breakfast? I need you to change them. Just kidding. Send it. Do you have it in the, do you have the envelope? Did you address them? Really? Is that, was that some for presentation?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
It's right there.
See, it's not even.
Oh, we have 5 people on now.
I don't know where to sit.
Seth, make a choice. So everybody else can have a seat, okay? All right, scooch in, bud. You gotta scooch in. Pretend you're. Well, you're supposed to scooch in this way. Let's scooch in this way. Okay? I don't see Fabian. Seth, it might be best if you're on the outside just because you're.
I can squish up in a little ball. There we go, we can fit everybody.
I don't want Noah out, though.
Noah's not out. See, he's on cam.
Well, it's delayed.
So
scoot closer to Graham. I'll tell you when to move. Scoot closer. Scoot a little bit closer. All right, there we go, friend.
Nice.
Okay, so first thing is, what was the most rewarding part about this Power and Government Global Issue Project? Maybe?
Well, I think the most rewarding part about this was getting to pay our own organization and getting to make our logo and to inform people about what we can do to help people who run out of
time. I think that the most rewarding part was probably finding out other people's perspectives on what they think the biggest issue around the world is and finding out what their ideas to solve it are.
And for me, I don't know what was the most, like, there were those that you have mentioned, like, in a way, I think the most rewarding would have been the presentations, because then we got to speak our mind and what we were trying to accomplish. We got the message out.
And I think the most rewarding part was getting to learn about all the different issues and how people are trying to solve
them. Okay, so second, what do you feel you learned most about your issue during this unit, Logan?
I learned the most about this unit, about, like,
probably for me is that I never realized on a scale how big the energy crisis was around the world until, we started this project, and how fossil fuels can be bad for the environment, and how renewable energies such as geothermal, solar, and so on can be better for the environment and more effective overall.
In a way, the most, what do you feel like you learned most about? Well, this is something that I learned that surprised me. It was about how America is only like 4.5% of the world and using 22% of the gasoline. That's just insane. It makes me realize I'm in the country, in a country that's just like, okay, we're pretty big, so we're gonna need bigger.
I learned most about how much pollution fossil fuels give off and how it's in the ozone layer.
Plus, third question. Which new tech learning outcome, NTLO, do you feel like you were the most successful during this unit?
I feel like I was the most successful.
The new tech learning outcome. See, the thing that I think I accomplished the most with was knowledge and thinking. I think, like, in a way, I don't feel like I accomplished that much, but I do know that I had accomplished knowing what I was talking about, at least, somewhat. And getting my research done so that I could present and they could understand what I was talking about. I don't know what I'm saying, but. Okay, so the fourth question.
Okay, so probably for me, it'd be most likely collaboration. Because at points, I think that I helped the group come together when we were at a disagreement and helped come up with ideas once we had a disagreement and found out each person's point of view and we tried to help solve that issue that we had.
I think I was the most successful in agency and collaboration because I worked well with them and I contributed some ideas that I
had. Okay. So, the fourth question, what is the one thing you want people to know about your global issue?
Well, I wanted them to know that fossil fuels are running out and they're harming the earth, and that we needed to use alternative energy, like wind energy.
Most likely what Fabian said, but in a deeper, more in-depth. I think probably that people should know that slowly, as we are running out of fossil fuels, people will still want energy once we do run out of that important resource. So we'll eventually have to find a different source of energy. And currently, the best and most efficient way to get energy is wind, and geothermal is getting better by the second, and more people are choosing wind energy for an alternative resource.
See, the one thing that I want people to know is that the ozone layer is being thinned by the smoke and exhaust coming from the fossil fuels we use, like coal and fuel. And that ozone layer is actually protecting us from UV ultraviolet light from the sun's rays, which can cause cancer. So the more we use it, the more we're thinning the ozone layer, higher chance we have of getting skin cancer from the sun's UV rays.
I just want people to know that.
Okay, so last and final question, on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest and 10 being the highest, what would you give this unit and why?
I would give this unit a 7 because I liked it, but there was some downsides to it.
I'd give this unit an 8 because it sort of did open up our eyes to know what the world is like currently and knowing the issues and not just what the good things are and knowing how us as learners can solve the problems and think about it more often.
I'd say I'd give this unit around a 7 because it does open up our eyes and it does tell us to, you know, maybe we should do this instead, maybe we should change this, but it does have its sort of flaws.
Yeah, I think
Like, if it was more innovative and took more creativity instead of just presenting it, like if your energy resources, do a little model, diagram. If you're this other thing, use some sort of thing to prove it. Like, if it mixed in with STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, a little bit more, like, if it was more of a big project with all of STEM and not just English and social studies, then that would certainly make this a much better project.
In my opinion, I'd give it a 7.5 because, like, right on the upside,
which case?
Hey,
did you do that?
Well, that's the last day of this week.
What was the most rewarding part of this power and government global issue project? What I thought was the most rewarding was knowing what you always take for granted and what people need and want, but those are the things that you take for granted every day.
Yeah, there's people all over the world that have to deal with issues all the time, and everybody just passes by them they just don't care about them.
What do you feel like you learned about your issue during this unit?
What I think I learned about this was about all the things that we take for granted while other people can still use the things that we take for granted. They want a better life, so they try to move to here. They leave everything behind to get to a better life, but we just take it off. What I learned most about this unit is that there's a whole bunch of global issues that nobody really cares about until they see it in their natural life.
Which new tech learning outcome NTLO do you feel you were the most successful with during this unit? The one that I thought we were most successful with was logic thinking, because most of the group already knew some of the things and knew something about migration, but we were still learning, and we did well on thinking of good ideas and I hate you. Okay,
so I feel we did good in collaboration, because we would always talk to each other and see what homework was done and when it was done, and we worked really good together. What was one thing that you want people to know about your global issue?
One thing that I want people to know about your global issue is that most people don't have what we have, and they won't. Some people leave their own country just to go to another country to have a better life, but they can't.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of people that just have to, or that are trying to move to a better place, that don't have war or inequality or problems, and there's not a lot of places without that.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what would you give this unit and why? I would give this unit a 9, because I already knew some things about migration, and I kept learning more things about what migration is and how it affects some.
I would rate it a 9 because I learned about
like migration and water resources and health and a whole bunch of global issues that are a whole bunch of global issues that make people have to suffer because they don't have as good as things as other people.
Camera or on the computer. You got six people watching. Alright.
So we're out of here in like 5 minutes. You guys need to get moving.
Okay. Alright. Okay. What was the most rewarding part of about the Powering Government project? I think the most rewarding part was learning that there are ways to save habitats that are going extinct.
I feel like the most rewarding was getting to pick our topic.
I would say getting more information.
What do you feel like you learned the most
in your issue? That habitats are being destroyed.
That people are just burning down the prairies to make homes and businesses.
People think that habitats aren't important. That's, which new tech learning outcome do you feel like you were the most successful with during this unit?
I feel like knowledge and thinking because I did good on that.
I also think knowledge and thinking because I got a good score on knowledge and thinking.
I think agency because I got all my stuff turned in on a good time.
What is one thing you want people to know about your global issue?
People are mean.
Okay, have it.
And that habitats are being destroyed.
That most of the prairies are gone and we need to save what's left of them.
Yeah, everyone likes to burn down prairies because they think that they're terrible and not good.
Okay. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, what would you give this unit and why?
I would give it a 4.5 because I didn't really enjoy it.
I'd give this unit a 7 because I liked some of what we did, but I didn't like some of the parts of what we did because it was mostly working on our global issue and not power and government.
I'd say 5 because it was kind of hard to find information.
I'd say 7 because we got to choose what we researched about and.
May I have your attention, please? I need you all to stop what you're doing, stop talking, and look up here, please.
I'm going.